Have you ever asked yourself, will Ethereum go up or down? Welcome to Daily Crypto Technical Analysis. You are watching Ethereum price prediction using technical indicators and price action. Right now, you can actually see Ethereum got a very nice bounce exactly at our daily support level at around $1,572. And at the moment, it does look like we are a little bit pulling to the upside. In this video, I'm going to tell you exactly where, in my opinion, you could be looking to go with a potential short position on Ethereum, because you need to know market structure at the moment, it's still looking bearish. And I am going to tell you exactly what are going to right now be our price targets if we are actually right now going to move even lower here on the Ethereum price. If you right now go with our Fibonacci retracement tool from the top of the move like this to the bottom of the move like this, you are going to see that our 0.32 Fibonacci level is actually very, very nicely aligning with the previous lows around $1,668. Our 0.5 Fibonacci level, $1,707, which is of course very nicely aligning with the previous highs. But let me right now show you this. If you go with exponential moving averages, you are going to see, doesn't really matter on what time frame you are going to go. Exponential moving averages for Ethereum right now are acting as our dynamic resistances. And at the moment, they are aligning also with our 0.5 Fibonacci level. 3 hour time frame, exactly the same thing. We have our exponential moving averages at 0.5 Fibonacci level. And also on the hourly time frame, our exponential moving averages are exactly at our 0.5 Fibonacci level. And because of that right now, exactly as I said in my Bitcoin price prediction video, if Ethereum right now is actually going to see a pull to the upside, let's say to our 0.32, maybe even to 0.5 Fibonacci level, around this area, in my opinion, would actually be a very nice opportunity to go with another short position on Ethereum. If we actually right now go with our weekly CPR levels, you are going to see that our weekly CPR level for Ethereum is also very, very close to our 0.5 Fib level and also our exponential moving averages. And because of that right now, if Ethereum sees a pull to the upside, right here, we actually have a very important resistance level, which is at around $1,703, where potentially you could be looking to go with a short position. As I said before, I'm going to talk about the price targets, how far we can see a pull to the downside, and also exactly where I would be looking to, of course, go with a short position. But if we right now go once again with our Fibonacci retracement tool, and we measure from the swing high right here to the swing low, you are going to see golden pocket for Bitcoin, very nicely aligning with our 0.382 Fibonacci level and also 0.786 Fibonacci level, very, very close to our 0.5 Fibonacci level right here. And because of that right now, if Ethereum once again sees a pull to the upside, short around 1,668, in my opinion, could be a very smart idea. And also around $1,707, where we actually right now have 0.786 Fibonacci level, 0.5 Fibonacci level, exponential moving averages, and as I showed you before, also weekly CPR levels literally are exactly right here. And because of that right now, if we let's say right now move to the upside around this zone, in my opinion, Ethereum right now has a bearish market structure. And because of that, there is also once again a better opportunity to go with a short position on Ethereum. But with that being said, I also want to cover right now a bullish scenario. What if Ethereum is going to see even bigger pull to the upside, let's say to our golden pocket around $1,757. You need to know, the higher we are going to go with the Fibonacci retracement tool here, the weaker is going to be the trend. And let me right now show you this. If you go right now with our volume profile, with our fixed range indicator and measure the entire move to the upside right here, you can right now see we are actually having our spike in the volume literally almost exactly where we are having our daily resistance level at around $1,776. And because of that right now, if Ethereum is going to see a pull to the upside to our daily resistance level right here, you need to know it is a very important resistance level where potentially you could be looking also once again to go with a short position. But you need to know something right now. If Ethereum is going to go to our daily resistance level right here, we are going to break, of course, our high right here on our lower time frame. And because of that, then on the lower time frames, you are going to see potentially we could be changing also our market structure. But once again, in my opinion, Ethereum has a very important resistance level, 0.5, 0.32 Fibonacci level right here, for a potential, let's say, short position on Ethereum. But what if right now we are actually going to see a pull to the downside, where is right now our very important support level for Ethereum? Weekly support level, of course, if we are breaking our daily support level right here, would be $1,422. But as I said before, in my opinion, I would definitely not be looking to take profits right here. I mean, this would be right now my second take profit. But in my opinion, weekly support level should not actually be your first take profit area. In my opinion, your first take profit area should be right here in the middle. But I am going to show you this a little bit later. If you right now go with the Fibonacci retracement tool, from the bottom of the move to the top of the move like this, 0.786 Fibonacci level, also very, very nicely aligning with our weekly support level. And also, if you would go with exponential moving averages, you are going to see on a daily time frame at the moment, it does look like our 100 exponential moving average is very nicely aligning with our weekly support level around $1,422. And because of that, we are having a very nice support level right here for Ethereum, $1,431. And because of that, definitely would be a very nice take profit area if we are going to right now move to the downside, let's say in the next couple of hours. But before right now, I actually show you why Ethereum right now is definitely having right now an average downtrend. And before I actually plan the trade for you, of course, if you haven't already right now, make sure you are smashing the like button, because today's goal is to reach 500 likes on this video. And if you're new here, make sure you are subscribed to the channel, because we are doing daily Bitcoin price predictions and also Ethereum price predictions every single day. And because of that, make sure right now you also have post notifications turned on. If we right now go with our simple moving averages, you are going to see 1 hourly time frame, we are in the average downtrend. 2 hourly time frame right now, you are going to see we are in an average downtrend. 3 hourly time frame, average downtrend. And also on the 4 hourly time frame, we are in the average downtrend. Because of that, if we are in the downtrend, you need to know trend is your friend. And because of that, I would be looking once again to go with another short position instead of a long position right now on Ethereum. And also right now, for example, if you would go on the daily time frame, you're going to see that we, of course, we also have our very important 50 exponential moving average on the daily time frame at the moment acting as our resistance level. But in my opinion, this 50 EMA on the daily, it's actually not that important. Yes, I mean, it is acting as our resistance level, but you need to know it's actually not aligning with any of the Fibonacci retracement tools, as I showed you before. And because of that right now, in my opinion, we actually have a much more important resistance level, as I said before, at our exponential moving averages, $1,700, maybe even a little bit lower, around $1,640 here on the Ethereum price. Before right now, I actually show you more bearish indications for Ethereum. And before I actually tell you what would be my first take profit area for Ethereum, if we are going to move lower, I would like to say this video is sponsored by PrimeXBT and their co-vesting copy trading feature. If you do not have the time or strategy to trade for yourself, you can just click on the follow button and you are going to copy exact same trades as another trader you choose. Co-vesting tab on PrimeXBT platform shows you the rating and performance of each trader. The more linear the graph is and the more stars they have, the better. Co-vesting is also a great tool for experienced traders to gain reputation and appreciation while earning additional gains from success fees. You can also join Co-vesting Telegram community, where you can chat with strategy managers and other members. Following strategies on Co-vesting copy trading module involves risk, so trade responsibly and please make your own research before following. The good news is that there are plenty of tools that will allow you to choose a strategy to follow based on how much risk are you willing to take. Use the promo code BitcoinHyper1 for 50% welcome bonus on your first deposit. Sign up links for PrimeXBT trading platform and their Telegram community are in the description below the like button. Right now, if we actually move on the 3 hourly time frame, you are going to see that on the MACD indicator, we could definitely right now be forming a potential bearish divergence. It is a higher low for Ethereum, higher high on the MACD indicator. This bearish divergence at the moment, it's definitely not confirmed. You need to wait for this one to start curving to the downside, but of course, would be a bearish divergence on the 3 hourly time frame. Exactly the same thing is happening on the 2 hourly time frame. Higher high, lower high right here. Of course, we are having a bearish divergence right now on 2 time frames on the MACD indicator. And also on the money flow indicator, exactly the same thing. Higher high, lower high right here. It is, of course, a bearish divergence for Ethereum. And because of that right now, of course, once again, a bearish indication. In my opinion, at this specific time would definitely not be the time to go with a long. I would still much rather right now go with a short position because of so many resistances right here, dynamic resistances, CPR levels, and also, of course, Fibonacci levels right here. And because of that bearish market structure, because of that, once again, I would be looking to potentially go with another short position on Ethereum. If we right now go on our buyers versus sellers indicator, you are going to see actually a bullish indication curving to the upside right now on the specific indicator. It does look like we are also crossing our zero line. 3 hourly time frame, let me show this, it's also curving to the upside, and also of course on the 4 hourly we are curving to the upside. But once again, because so many indicators right now are actually looking a little more bearish, market structure is also looking bearish, and because of it, in my opinion, yes, we could see a pull to the upside, let's say to our resistance level. But here, once again, I would potentially be looking to go with a short because it is a very strong resistance level being formed here with all of the tools I actually showed you already. So with all that being said, where in my opinion I would be actually going with a short, and also where would be my first take profit area if we are going to move lower. As I said before, 0.382, 0.5 Fibonacci level in this area, in my opinion, could be of course a potential short position. If we go once again with our exponential moving averages, you need to know, if you're going to set your stop loss above the EMAs, EMAs at the moment are acting as our dynamic resistances, and because of that, your stop loss can actually be protected with those dynamic resistances on the Ethereum chart. And because of that, let's say your stop loss could actually be around $1,742. And once again, where would be my first take profit area if you are going to go with a short position? In my opinion, of course, if you're going to target the daily support level, risk to reward ratio of the specific trade is definitely not going to be valid. And because of that, your first take profit area could be weekly CPR level right here, let's say at around $1,511, or then the next one, weekly support level, $1,425. But you need to know, daily support level right here on Ethereum is also very, very important. And there is also a probability we are going to form a higher low right here. Of course, once again, a potential double bottom. And because of that, I would be also looking to maybe set my stop loss to break even when and if right now we are going to see a pull to the upside, and then of course a pull to the downside, stop loss to break even, let's say at 1-to-1 risk to reward ratio. Because of that, you are going to then be in the risk-free trade if, for example, right now we are then going to form some kind of a double bottom. But once again, if the risk to reward ratio of your trade is not valid, personally, I would not actually be looking to actually take profits. Once again, I gave you the price target. It is going to be our weekly CPR level for Ethereum around $1,510. Take the profits a little bit earlier before the exact target. And then, of course, you have the next one, weekly support level, $1,422 here on the Ethereum chart. If you haven't already, make sure right now you are smashing the like button, because today's goal is to reach 500 likes on this video. If you haven't already, subscribe to the channel, because we are doing daily Bitcoin price predictions, Ethereum price prediction videos every single day. And because of that, make sure right now you are subscribed to the channel and turn on post notifications. Right now, you can watch one of those two videos that are popping up on your screen. Thank you for watching, and peace out.